how are you doing? Good?
Alright, let's go to our December 15th class. Before I start talking about the test, don't forget to like our video and subscribe to our channel, okay? Good. This text is about the introduction of nylon as a viable commercial product. Its characteristics allowed it to be used from clothing to car parts and toothbrushes, right? And it started being used in stockings, but later other industries started to see its potential and started to develop new uses for it. Some verbs in the text. We're gonna have the verbs to enter, to claim, to match, to help, to decide, to focus, to continue, to rise, to provide, and to knit. Alright? So let's see home practice. It starts on page 1514 and finishes on page 1515. On the first activity for junior, seniors, and masters, you guys had to tell us the steps on how to make nylon according to the video. Okay? So, the first step is to break up logs into a pulp mill, and then wood is chopped up and cooked, and now this goes to the rayon mill, or they put it into tanks. Then they fill the tank with a chemical, and after that they take it out and drop it down through a hole to the floor below into a machine. This machine breaks it up into small pieces. When the pulp comes out, it's broken up into fluffy crumbs. These crumbs go to a room to age a couple of days, and then it goes to another machine like a churn. The next step is to dissolve this in another chemical, and then we are ready to make it into a fiber. In a tube, we draw in some of the liquid, force it out through a tiny hole on the end of this tube, and then the acid hardens it, and here is our rayon fiber. The cloth, with coal and many other things, is called nylon. Alright? And then on letter B, you guys had to write down as many verbs in the imperative form as you could get from the video. Some examples: to chop, cook, mix, see, finish, make, control, get, boil, go, and come. Alright? Then, seniors had to record an audio summarizing the nylon production process according to the video. So, summarizing it, logs are chopped and cooked, then mixed with chemicals. After holding off a few days, the pulp goes into another machine, then it's dissolved with more chemicals and turned into a fiber in a third machine. Masters had to do the same, but also using accessories and language chunks. So let's go to our review. As you could imagine, this review is about giving instructions. We're gonna focus on two modal verbs, should and must, a semi-modal, have to, and imperatives. Should and must, they are modal verbs. Should will transmit the idea of a recommendation, a suggestion, or advice. Must will transmit the idea of obligation. Examples using should and must. One should match his clothes properly. Or, you must not decide what to wear in the last minute. Okay? Have to will transmit the idea of a necessity or an obligation. An example: clothes have to provide both comfort and style. And imperatives will transmit the idea of orders, instructions, commands. Okay? For example, continue to dress what you like and not what your friends like. Alright? And that's it for this class. Now guys, you are able to watch your live class with your teacher and do the class practice activities on your book. Okay? So thank you so much. Have a great day and see you on our next class. Bye-bye.